tents erected in a Brisbane park, a miserable sign of Queensland's growing crisis. The rate of homelessness there jumping more than 20% in 6 years.
We know that we simply don't have enough houses to house all of the people in this state.
In Canberra, a rally calling on the government to do more.
And we need to be prepared to tackle this problem seriously and not throw a bucket of water on a bushfire.
Australia buckling under a housing crisis.
People who have never faced housing stress before in their lives, contemplating homelessness.
And the federal government's flagship $10 billion Housing Future Fund policy is on shaky ground.
If people think that it's a great idea to say that they support more investment in social housing, but knock back a $10 billion fund that will build more social and affordable housing, then good luck having that argument.
A major election promise, it needs the backing of the Greens and at least two Senate crossbenchers to pass. The plan? To invest $10 billion, then spend the dividends, up to $500 million a year, building 30,000 social and affordable homes in the first 5 years.
This dodgy housing bill, I believe, is a form of gambling. Investing some money and hoping for a return to build public housing, what a joke!
A leader passionate about social housing.
I grew up not far from here, in Sydney, in public housing, the son of a single mum.
Possibly facing his first major legislative defeat. The Greens demanding more.
There's nothing in this package that is going to make life easier for renters.
640,000 Aussie households are currently in housing stress. By 2041, that number is expected to be 1 million.
This is a national crisis. What you're saying is no to actually getting homes on the ground for people that need it most.
We can do better. And just saying this is better than nothing is not a good policy response.
More supply means cheaper rents. The fact is that we have a comprehensive plan on housing. Those opposite, like in everything else, just have a plan to say no.
Max Chandler-Maher is the Greens housing spokesperson. Late today, we should point out, negotiations with the government hit a roadblock. They'll now be parked until budget week in May. So, Max, there are going to be people on waiting lists right now and they're begging for this bill to pass. What do you say to them? Why won't you back the policy?
Well, firstly, under the government's plan, they don't spend a single cent up front on housing. And, in fact, the first home under their plan wouldn't be built until 2025. And that's because they're getting $10 billion of public money and gambling on the stock market and hoping they get returns. And last year, that gamble would have lost $120 million. All we're saying is the government should come up front and spend $5 billion a year right now on public and affordable housing so we can get homes on the ground right now and not have to wait till 2025.
Now, this is just one of the measures on the government's agenda to tackle housing. Do you not accept that it is part of a bigger picture?
They have said this is their centrepiece plan to tackle the housing crisis, and this is their long-term plan to tackle the housing crisis, and it doesn't include anything for renters, and wants to build at most 6,000 homes a year, at most, by the way, because last year, as I said, the fund lost $120 million. And, you know, this is a government that just found $368 billion for the nuclear subs, you know, down the back of the couch for their budget, but they can't find extra money for public and affordable housing. It beggars belief. And at the same time, they're saying for the one-third of renters, they have nothing. And in fact, they're doing worse than nothing because they're cutting funding for 27,000 affordable NRAS homes as well. Like, this is going to make the housing crisis worse. So, of course, we want the government to come to the table and propose a plan that actually starts to lift people out of housing stress.
Yeah, but it's not true to say they're doing nothing for renters, because they've got the National Housing Accord that aims to build a million new homes over 5 years. So that's starting from 2024. Their whole argument is that the way you bring rents down is by increasing the number of dwellings, because that changes the market conditions, there's more competition, rents come down. You may not agree with the policy, but that doesn't mean they're doing nothing. It's just that you don't like what they're doing.
Well, no, it's not a million homes. What they've said is that's an aspirational target. And to be clear, last 5 years, there were a million homes built in Australia. And they've said, oh, the private industry will build a million homes in the next 5 years as well. And that's what got us in the crisis in the first place, which is relying on private property developers to make a big buck building luxury apartment towers. Literally the only funding they announced in that announcement for a million homes was they said they would build 10,000 affordable homes, without defining affordable, over the next 5 to 10 years. Like, that's not a housing plan. And to be clear, rents are going up right now. Like, we have a proposal to freeze rent increases for the next 2 years. The government could adopt it right now. And that would mean that real renters right now contemplating, and I'm sure a lot of you on this panel might know someone who's going through this, they're about contemplating $150, $200 a week rent increase. And it's reasonable to say rents have gone up enough and everyone needs a bit of relief. That's all we're asking for.
Max, people have been waiting on the public housing list in New South Wales, for example, for more than 10 years. They're sick of the fighting. They just want solutions now. So what will it take for the Greens to support this? What changes are you wanting?
Well, the government's own body, the National... It's a boring name, I'm sorry. The National Housing Finance Investment Corporation. Try and say that three times fast. They've proposed... they've said to the government, we need $15 billion of investment every year in social and affordable housing to tackle the housing crisis. We, the Greens, have said, look, we want to negotiate, so we've suggested the federal government chip in a third of that, $5 billion a year in public and affordable housing, and in the context of a federal budget that's very moderate.
Max, thanks so much for your time. Appreciate it.
Thank you.